Morning folks, welcome to another episode of Savannah State Home Safaris. So myself and Ali just started out for the morning and come across these two hyenas here on the dam wall. Obviously had a good feed, nice full belly on that one. We're hoping there's still going to be some lions in the area. That's obviously going to be a good way to start the day. So let's see how we go. So very awesome that we've come across the large herd of buffalo again. Always great to see them in the area. What's really getting us excited is we've actually got tracks of the lions, what we think is the Ottawa pride, also coming into this area, coming this way. At the moment it doesn't look like the buffalo have been hassled or they're certainly not looking too stressed out. So maybe not been in contact with the lions yet, but we've certainly got tracks coming into this area. So we're going to keep going, keep doing a few loops around, and let's hope we get lucky with that Ottawa pride. See the buffaloes going about their business there. Clearly see them having a good old wallow, trying to get that mud to cover over those sort of hard to reach places where those oxpeckers and those external parasites are certainly bothering them, giving them those irritating bites and itches and scratches. So nice to see them sort of covering their coats with that mud, and that's certainly going to aid in a bit of sun protection and stop the irritating, and certainly much needed in the hot climate that we have here. Not quite what we were looking for, but nice little bonus. We've got Clumbella here, and just as we were pulling out of that herd of buffalo, Lawrence and the trackers said that they had spotted a leopard. So very awesome to see it. Clumbella, bold as his young male cub, or young male adult as we say now. So nice to see him. Obviously caught up in that herd of buffalo. That's not where he wants to be. So he's slowly angling away from that herd now. So we'll keep up with him and see what he gets up to. Right, so as we just watched Lambela disappear into the thick stuff there, certainly a nice little bonus to see him again, and great to see he's looking good and coming along nicely, growing up fast. Awesome to be around those leopards when they're at that sort of age, young, curious, playful, and just great to see him. So Lambela doing well, always a nice one to see. Let's keep cracking and let's see if we can get lucky with those lions. So we kind of put all our eggs in one basket this morning in hoping that these lions were going to make an attempt at those buffalo, that large herd of buffalo we had. But just looking at the pride now, it seems like the big Matimba male and one of the older adult females is missing. So maybe just lacking that muscle power, that punch with a complete pride put them off a little bit. But nevertheless, still great to see them, and obviously in the cooler weather, looking a bit more active than usual, which is great. So one thing that we're certainly starting to notice more and more is how the males are starting to bond and almost starting to sort of get that instinct of that coalition going. So you've got the two younger males and then that slightly older sort of sub-adult male, and they're really starting to come into their own. And classic Keisha, you've got the female sort of resting up, and then the male's very active and starting to enjoy their own company together, which is great to see. The younger adult female seems to have looped around. We can see some zebra in the distance, and the rest of the pride, as you can see, just hanging back here, waiting to see what that other female's approach is. So we're still trying to work out where the other lioness has gone. We assume she's done a loop around. We've got zebras alarm calling. We've also got impalas that we heard. And as you can see, the rest of the pride is also trying to figure out where that other female is. So let's do a loop around and let's see if we can see what all the fuss is about. So we've just heard some contact calling, so it sounds like the other females are trying to get the pride back together. Let's hope that she's got a bit of success with the kill. So happily all back together, but sadly no kill. See the lioness panting quite heavily there, and I think she was involved in the initial chase, but sadly no success this time. Right folks, without overstaying our welcome too much, we've got a big storm rolling in as well, so I think that's our cue. We're going to leave it for the day, but another fantastic outing with Hlambela. Obviously the lions in action, a bit of activity, nothing better than that. So we're going to head back and let's hope we can stay dry between here and home. Right, so it took us a while to get going this morning. As you can see, a little bit of blue sky starting to appear in the background there. Had some rain through the night, nothing unusual to have a bit of winter rain, always appreciated. Nothing too much to sort of fill up the watering holes or anything, but as you can see, nice and wet, nice and damp, and certainly settled the dust, which is always appreciated. We've managed to get onto the Otwa Pride's tracks again from where we left them last night, so we're going to keep going and let's hope that they can give us a good sighting. Right folks, so it felt like pretty much a wild goose chase all day trying to get onto these lions, onto the Otwa Pride. Eventually managed to get a sighting and it looks like they've had a kill. A young giraffe, possibly been eating through parts of the day and almost finishing up there, it seems. You can see them with their nice full bellies. And sadly, obviously, some of the giraffes, some of the herd over here are still hanging around. Trying to work out what's happened to the young one. But great to see the pride again after all those attempts we saw yesterday. Great to see them eventually on a kill, on a meal, and looking good. Right, so great to see the otters again, and like we say, a full belly, well fed, and certainly satisfied. And I think we're going to leave them there. and let's see if we can go squeeze in another sighting before the sun goes down. So great to see Tamba also with a bit of success. He's got a fully grown impala kill hoisted up the tree here. Obviously hyenas at the base patiently waiting their turn for gravity to take its place. But for now it looks like he's certainly stashed it safely up there in the tree in the fork. And as you can see, he's been feeding as well and got a nice full belly on him. Just great to see Tamba again. I think it's been a while since we've seen him. So also just interesting to point out there how those hyenas are still attentive to the leopard's movements. And as soon as they see or hear him moving about, they know that there's a chance he's going to move towards that kill. And then obviously with him feeding and trying to get comfortable, there's a good chance that that's when he's going to drop it. And then of course, they're busy just waiting for that. So you can see how intelligent these hyenas are with still being able to see exactly what's going on with the leopard up in the tree. So something worth mentioning is just how we've seen after that cold, wet, stormy weather we had last night, we've managed to see two sets of predators, the otters with that young giraffe kill and our Tamba with his impala kill hoisted up the tree here. That windy, stormy weather certainly seems to play into the predator's favor. And obviously the sound of the rain, the wind swirling around, obviously sort of masks that predator's scent and the movements, and it makes it incredibly difficult for your antelope and your prey species. So just interesting to think how you know, as tempting as it is to stay indoors when you get those cold sort of wet days out on safari, it is often worth just braving it and heading out, because certainly as you can see, we've been successful today in getting some great activity with the leopard and the lions on that kill. So Tamba certainly looks content up there. He's comfortable, he's got a full belly, he's out of the way of the irritating hyenas. So we're going to leave him be. We've been sat here for about 20-30 minutes and it looks as if he's settled in. So we're going to crack on while we've got a little bit of light, and let's see what else we can conjure up. Right folks, it's really been an awesome a couple of days, and I'm sure you can agree we've had it all. We've had some ellies, the buffalo, great sighting with the predators, and then that rain as well, just to throw it in there, but still happy with the day's outcomes despite the miserable weather. But great to be out, and thanks for watching Savannah Stay at Home Safaris, and we're going to see you next time.